Okay, we're going to start with the breathing. So what I'm going to do is get the two middle fingers touching underneath the breastbones, palms and lower lobes of lungs, just so you can see the breath going into the lower lobes of lungs, into costals, the ribs, anywhere but the stomach. Because as you zip up pelvic floor and scoop out your abdominals, just breathe into these lower lobes of lungs. Lovely stuff. Now as you do that, breathe in through the nose now, out through the nose. Because it's a smaller filter through the nose, it helps us lengthen the breath even longer, especially that lovely elongated out breath, which is always longer than the in breath. That's going to help us mount into these postures and get these postures even easier. So as you keep on breathing into these lower lobes of lungs, you're zipping up pelvic floor or pulling up from the perineum and gathering the belly button. It's going to help us breathe low and deep into these lower lobes of the lungs. Now, if you want to, if you want to go to ujjayi breath is we're restricting the esophagus, the back of the throat, and it's like a Darth Vader type breath. It's like a with the mouth shut, sighing, whistling even, silky breath. Okay, so we're breathing through the nose and exhaling through the nose. Get that nice resonant sound from the back of the throat. Ujjayi breath, victorious breath, whistling silky breath. It's going to give the mind something to focus on, help us lengthen the breath in the postures, help stimulate the thymus gland, which helps with weight control, etc., and builds the heat in the body. Lovely. So let's link that to vinyasa, breath synchronized movement. So we've come towards the end of our mats, hands in namaste. Okay, feet together, and it's nature's rule, not mine, just to find our balance. So what we're going to do is roll forward and back. Again, as if we're sort of swishing a bucket of water from side to side. We stop swishing that bucket of water from side to side, and these movements can get smaller and smaller and smaller and smaller, until we just stop. So we're nice on the ball and the heel, nice and even. Do a little bit of a Mexican wave. You watch my feet, a little Mexican wave. Little toe to big toe, just so we lengthen out between big toe and little toe, like a Mexican wave. Okay, you can imagine there's a tripod from big toe to little toe to the centre of your heel, just root us in towards the floor, zip up pelvic floor, scoop out abdominals, hands in namaste, here we go, so from here, a nice slow salute and a fast one. Tadasana, mountain pose. Lovely stuff. From here, we're going to breathe in coming up. Setu Tadasana, extended mountain pose. Exhaling down to Utkasana, the fire posture. Again, knees in line with toes, no deeper. Excuse me. Knees in line with toes, no deeper. And we've got that inner thigh connection kicking onto the pelvic floor, which then kicks onto the corset, the powerhouse, the girdle of strength. Three layers deep. Just all segmentally stabilising our spines. We're focusing on our trishti, our focus point is our thumbs. That's our focus point. This mudra grip, this energy seal here, we focus on the thumbs. And that's the only rule. Just breathe on each stroke, or breathe on each move, then breathe into the postures and beyond when you get there, while elongating the out breath longer than the in breath. It's going to help us melt into these postures even easier. Lovely stuff. You can imagine them roots just growing up and nourishing the body from the floor. Lovely stuff. Utkasana, the fire posture. Just breathing in the fan of fire to burn all the toxins in the body. Utkasana. You can imagine you're breathing in pure clay white light, just coming to the nerve system and helping everything feel even more relaxed than it already is. As the body feels even more relaxed than it already is, we're going to exhale down, collapsing inwards, dying off. Thinking tiny waist, nave towards spine, hanging nice and loosely. Like a rag doll, or a wet rag doll, nice and loose, or a wilting flower. Lovely stuff. So there's a magnet on our spine, pulling the belly button in. Or there's a little rib cord on the belly button, pulling the belly button in towards the spine. Collapsing inwards, dying off, thinking
and sukha, pliability, without even trying or trying on trying. For every out breath, just unravel your unique to the moment. Uttanasana, lovely scarf. And from here, we're still looking to untie the knots that bound you with that lovely elongated out breath, just always longer than the in breath. From here, we're going to breathe in, come on the floor, to chaturanga dandasana. Chaturanga dandasana. Do you want to say that fast? And from there, chaturanga dandasana, plank pose, press up pose on the knees or the toes. Okay, wrists in line with shoulders, feet in line with hips. We're going to exhale down, slowly lower that weight under control, exploiting gravity. Hover with the nose, length through the toes, gathering away from that grape on the floor, the belly button, to reveal a bit of daylight between the floor and the belly button. If there's something slivering underneath the belly button, we're going to breathe in, rolling that marble very gently by the nose, lowering maintains contact with the ground. The breastbone looks at the wall, so there's a breastbone there with an eye in it, looking at the wall. There's an eye in your breastbone, looking at the wall. Lovely stuff. That pull of water in the back of your head, melt down to the shoulders, melt the shoulders away from the ears. It's a perfectly good Bhujanga Sana Cobra from here. If you've got the feet very gently outside, hip width apart, that helps us use the middle 12 vertebrae back, the hump region of the back, thoracic part of the back, which only bear up against gravity in everyday life. You can either stay here, or take a facial cheek at any time, or come onto the elbows and sphinx over here, or coming up further from here into the full Bhujangasana Cobra. Okay. Now again, you can always drop back a level if need be, elbows into the side, shoulders slide around the ribcage, so like magnets slide around the fridge. This index finger is pointing inwards, okay, pointing inwards. So we get the inner trine of the wrist, inner two knuckles, inner wrist, inner two knuckles, inner wrist. Lovely. Spread them fingers, middle fingers forward. And just find that spot in the wall. And just lose yourself in the breath. Come into the here and now, the breath, the present moment, the breath. And breathing to pacify the body of any shaking. Lovely stuff. Just finding that spot on the wall to open up the brow chakra between the eyebrows. Then from the crown, sarasa, away from the tailbone, muladhara. Gathering in manipura, the belly button, above the belly button. And gaze swadhisthana on the pelvic floor. And breathe that space behind the heart and a hatha. And again, get that ujjayi breath from the back of the throat, vishuddha. Simply open up the seven seas of energy from the crown to the tailbone. Then when you're ready, we're going to breathe in coming up onto the knees. Tuck the toes under. And we're going to exhale back to our hamasana, swan posture. Or breathing and exhaling further back into our balasana. Okay, hands in here. Or to the front. Feel over. These are both modifications for the downward dog. You can either stay here or drop out to these poses at any time. Or breathing, coming up onto all fours. Tuck the toes under and exhale up into Adimetta Svanasana, the downward dog. Feet can be together in a Shivananda style or slightly parted. It needs to be bent or straight. Remember, it's your yoga, it's your union of your mind and body. So don't be frightened of edging round with the postures. Always searching for somewhere to feel slightly more relaxed than the postures. And then from there, even lengthen out between big toe, little toe. Spread them fingers, middle fingers forward. Heading towards the tailbone. You can shake that head very loosely and loosen that close relationship with the neck and the jaw. Soften the valley between the cheek and the nose. And even stick the tongue to the roof of the mouth. That's going to open up the conception vessel. opening vessel, running from the crown to the tailbone, to the tailbone to the crown. Also, it's going to help that close relationship with the jaw and the neck. And then when you're ready, we're going to calibrate and synchronize the breath and movement. Integrate the breath and the movement. Breathing right leg forward first. Breathing right leg forward. So you're Vrudrasana, the warrior. So from here, check the outside bone, the little toe side of the foot, the lead leg, is straight. That put the foot nicely aligned. Lead knee over lead ankle. Okay. Lead heel right in the centre of the rear arch of the foot. It's like a T stance. Okay. Lovely stuff. And even lengthen out, trim big toe, little toe of the lead leg. Okay. Shoulders over hips, head over shoulders. Hands come up below the shoulders. You can imagine there's wild horses pulling you apart from the arms. Focus on nutrition. Your focus point is your middle finger. Okay, just focus on that and root yourself in. Lovely stuff. Still looking to surrender this posture in breath. Still have that strength and dignity to hold this posture and root yourself in. Lovely stuff. And that lovely gentle rise and fall of the ribcage, just signifying the senses of detaching and just slowing down. Lovely stuff. We're going to exhale down, collapsing inwards, dying off. Square up the back leg. Chaturanga Dandasana. Plank pose, press up pose on your knees or your toes. Breathing, coming back to here. Exhaling down. Slowly lower the weight under control. Exploiting gravity. Elbows near sides, if possible. Hobble the nose. Lengthen through the toes. Gathering away from that grape on the floor, the belly button. Draw a little bit of daylight between the floor and the belly button. As if there's something slivery underneath the belly button. Pour the water in the back of your head, melt down to the shoulders, melt the shoulders away from the ears. As you breathe in, you're rolling that marble very gently on your nose. Lower it, maintains contact with the ground. The breastbone looks at the wall. So there's an eye on your breastbone, looking at the wall. That pour the water in the back of your head, just melt them down to the shoulders, and the shoulders away from the ears. A perfect good Bhujangasana Cobra from here. If you've got the feet very gently outside.